Mr. Speaker.
John Hayes.
I find it really disappointing that both the Labor Party and the Green Party are opposing this legislation, because I think it's really important that all New Zealanders support the arts. And if we're going to encourage all New Zealanders to support the arts, then we need to move the community view from the government's going to put its hand in the pocket to pay for it to let's all share the burden and let's encourage philanthropy. And there are many hundreds of New Zealanders who are very supportive of the arts. I think about people like Mike Camp here in Wellington, or Fran Ricketts in Auckland, or Richard Cathy, or Ron Scott up in Upper Hutt, or Chris Parkinson across town. These are people, the Deans, Rod and Gillian Dean, Eon and Jan Edgar down in Queenstown, John Todd here in Wellington. These are people whose names crop up time and time and time again, because they're the ones we go to say, would you please give us some money for this purpose or other? And these people are very, very important people in our community for the contributions that they make from their pocket to the growth of arts and our culture in this country. But the solution in encouraging those people continuing to give to the arts, and more importantly, to grow the pie by engaging with the 30 and 40-year-olds in our community to get them into the business of supporting the arts, is not to have some sort of wasteful, top-heavy, laborious group of or collection of entities that are all involved in developing strategy and ideas and having meaningless discussions about the arts, rather than getting on with the practical business of efficiently running the structure. And I particularly want to commend Chris Finlayson, picking up on Grant Robertson's comments about what a wonderful job the Minister does in actually putting his own hand in the pocket and contributing to the arts. He knows what has to be done. When was the last time, Mr. Cosgrove, you made a contribution to culture in New Zealand by buying a painting or even visiting an art gallery? You must come and have a look at Te Papa one day. I'm pleased that your art gallery in Christchurch didn't suffer too badly in the earthquake. And I hope that, but when I was there last time, nobody had even seen you set foot inside it, such as your support for the arts. No, you're into creating jobs for all sorts of people by having top-heavy structures. We're not going to go down that road. I commend the Minister for compressing the administration into an efficient entity, because if we don't have efficient management of the arts, we are not going to encourage philanthropists to put their money in to grow that business. I'd just finally like to wind up by saying, Mr. Speaker, that about 3% of the total arts funding comes from private donors, from gifts, from people like Mr. Cosgrove, who donate generously to the arts. 3%. What we have to do is to encourage young people into the business of giving, and I'm very pleased that John Key helped to do that by lifting the cap on the amount of money people could donate to good works. Mr. Speaker, I have not the slightest reservation in supporting this legislation, and commend the Minister for bringing it back to the House. Thank you.
Tracy Martin.
Kia ora, Mr. Speaker. Thank you. I rise on behalf of New Zealand First to speak in support.